So what is this platform that you built?
Well, this is the Omni Wrist, and this is designed for robot surgery. And we're building something a little more rugged, a little more flexible, mm-hmm. a little more dexterous than what's been done before. And this is the very first prototype. This was built in a little shop. And then from this, we've gone to this prototype, which is the next generation, more compact, more, this one has a little gripper on the end. We can see in the video here it operating. So it's robot evolution is what's happening.
From what I can see, it looks like there's three lead screws and they're all connected to three different rods.
Yes,
and
exactly.
And you're able to bend and twist.
Exactly. But what's kind of unique about this is this disc here is like a mirror, and we reflect the lower drivetrain to the upper drivetrain. So it's a mirroring or doubling of the range of motion. But it's easy to make things that can move a little bit like this. Yeah. It's very hard to make things that can go like this and move around. In effect, this is a new form of high angulation, constant velocity, universal joint. You heard the term CV joint. That stands for constant velocity. This is a constant velocity joint, like in your car, but it can steer your wheel a lot further than you normally would be able to.
Yeah, and so is your background, are you with the company?
Yeah, this is my company, Ross-Hime Designs, and we've been around for a long time, but we just recently came up with this new technology, and we're excited to present it here at IEEE. ICRA. So
definitely a lot of applications in the medical surgical world.
Exactly.
It's the most glaring one. Is there any other applications that you...
Well, you can scale this up and you can make humanoid joints. You can make shoulders, spines. This has an unusual capability as Z-axis. So you can imagine a robot that can, you know, move its arms, telescope out and do a kind of unusual non-human motions.
It would be a slow motion though, right? Much slower than its... ability to bend.
Actually, because it's so simple and it's using simple off-the-shelf components, it can be very fast and reach human speeds, which are, people are very fast. That's one of the reasons why animatronics at Disney have been hydraulic for so long. These casual movements we make every day are pretty darn fast. But with this new technology, we think we can do it with electric motors and have the same speed of hydraulics just with using electricity.
Yeah, and what's extremely impressive about this is its diameter.
It's very hard to make small, it's easy to make big. And the fact that we can make this one was made out of hobby store components, that we could find off-the-shelf components and make this is a small miracle. Mm-hmm. And it's taken me, you know, 40 years to get to this. Mark Twain said, "I don't have time to write a short letter." It to get simple is hard.
Yeah.
You got to go through all these dead ends and all these things. But we're excited about the commercial potential for this, and we're hoping that there'll be thousands of these someday.
Yeah. So this is something that you're looking to license to larger companies.
Exactly. We're the kind of their R&D branch, and they have the capability, the marketing ability, the sales and engineering to take this into mass production.
Awesome. And when is this state of the, is this a prototype now?
Yeah.
When is this state of the prototype? When was it made?
Okay, this was made about maybe 4 years ago. And then recently, with the addition of some new funding, we built this. This was current. This was this year. So there was a little lull between these. This is what I presented on at the conference, this particular one.
Amazing. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
And then the disc is the one that you said is right in the middle.
Yeah, exactly.
And then that allows it to bend at a higher angle.
Right, because you see the lower half is identical to the upper half. And that doubling of motion, it's like you've just duplicated, you photocopied the lower joint, you know.